you need to know about .NET standard. But today we would be discussing more about history of .NET, what is all these different names. And let me start with telling a few things about me. So I am a 24 years old full stack developer. I have 4 years of experience in .NET. I have no education as a software engineer. I love comics such as Marvel and Invincible. And today is my first ever presentation, so don't be too harsh. At first, I would like to say, why does this presentation exist? So you've all probably heard about .NET standard. It's been around us for like 3-4 years probably. And it is one of the top questions in the interview. But the thing is, a lot of people who I've been interviewing didn't know about such concepts as .NET Core, .NET Framework. They were missing understanding of .NET standard. Their knowledge of this topic was not full, for, in my opinion. That's why I wanted to create like a point of reference for future conversations. Like, hey, if you don't know what it is, you can just check like this video or materials in this training for future use. Let me start with like a history recap. I imagine in this picture, like first monkey was .NET 1, or maybe not even .NET 1, but more like CLR. And I would like to tell you about evolution from .NET 1 to .NET 6, and how did it change in terms of compatibility, in terms of evolution, and what changed exactly. So biggest problem for .NET framework, in my opinion, was Linux, because Linux is used in a cloud. So if you want your language to be highly used in a cloud, or you want it to be efficient or fast in a cloud, you would like it to be able to run from Linux distributive. And the problem with .NET is everyone considered .NET a Windows-only language. So it was hard to tell people that we were actually being able to use Linux as our software OS. Some of you may tell me that, hey, we had Mono, and Mono gave us possibility to run .NET, C Sharp, or any CLR language from a Linux distributive. But the thing is, with Mono, it was not developed by Windows. It was developed by open source team, which later on joined .NET team and developed .NET Core, but about it a bit later. So during existence of .NET, from .NET 1 till .NET Framework 4.0, I believe, there was two different kind of implementations of .NET for Windows and for all other systems. And that was a big problem, because not all implementations followed the same rules. Not everything was in one line. So in order to change .NET into cross-platform solution, Microsoft had to do a lot of steps, like rewrite compiler, change CLR, change BCL, update frameworks. And along the way, they changed not only compatibility issues, so it's not only is able to run from different operation systems right now, but they also changed a lot of pitfalls, like they changed architectural style, and .NET is now faster and not only cross-compatible. After Mono, they introduced a .NET Core 3 or 4 years ago. And I started my development process from actually .NET Core, or all my .NET framework experience was in university or in my Hello World projects. So we actually have a generation of developers who haven't tried .NET framework. And for them, it might be interesting about how it developed. So after introducing .NET Core, we had a thing called .NET Standard Library. And it was something that was used by .NET Framework, .NET Core, Xamarin, and all other solutions to implement library. And the first thing I want to tell is everyone think that .NET Standard is just a thing which helps us to create libraries. And I would like to say that full understanding of .NET Standard is a list of restrictions which frameworks should implement in order to be able to be in the future of .NET family. So in .NET Standard 1.6, were introduced rules which all the other frameworks should implement. And that's how I believe it works. You all probably have seen this table of compatibility issues. In the top, you see different .NET Standard versions. And on the bottom, you see different frameworks that support it. So let's say from .NET Standard 1.6, you could write libraries in a .NET Framework 4.6.1, Xamarin OS 10.0, and Unity 2018.1. So it gave us possibility to run, to create libraries, which could be used in a different platforms. .NET 5 is a future version of .NET Core, so there would be no .NET Core 4.0, let's per se. It would be called .NET 5. And previously, we had still two different branches, like .NET Framework and .NET Core were developing not alongside, but rather with different approaches. .NET 5 now should unite all this platform, and there would be no .NET Standard, there would be no .NET Core, .NET Framework. Everything would be united for like in one simple name. And also from, I already mentioned that .NET Mono was developed by open source, but from .NET Core 1.0 version, Microsoft started highly coupled communication with this open source team. And actually, Mono team joined Microsoft later on in their development. So if you probably will write some cool new library or cool new framework, or you will update a huge chunk of .NET, you may be considered to be a part of .NET team, so don't hesitate. Not all of you have probably seen this picture of .NET schedule. So if .NET 5 is the next new big thing and everyone should use it, why a lot of people are not using it yet, even if it was released like in November 2020? The thing is, .NET 5 is not yet LTS version. It's just a general release, so it's not long-term supported. And huge enterprise companies probably would start using .NET from a .NET 6.0, not .NET 5.0, because of this small issue. And you could see that the last version of .NET Core was actually released in November 2019. So I've told you like basic information of what .NET Standard, .NET Framework, and .NET Core is. And next part of my presentation is telling you how to migrate from .NET Framework, which tools could be useful, and what pitfalls you could see on your road to the next .NET version. The first thing I would like to tell you about is .NET Portability Analyzer. It could be used both from console and from Visual Studio. You can download extension, and it would analyze dependencies of your applications, of your libraries, and tell you what should you change and What exactly could be updated later on. Next thing is .NET Upgrade Assistant. This tool gives you a step-by-step solution what to do in case you need to upgrade from .NET Framework to .NET 5 or from .NET Core 3.1 to .NET 5. And I will tell you these tools in a minute. Let me open my project for a moment. Yeah. So I created a couple of libraries. I don't know if I will show all of them, but for .NET compatibility tool, I would pick up one of old repositories and show you how to analyze it on dependencies. So let's pick up old framework project. Let's see which version of .NET it is supporting. You could see it runs .NET Framework 3.5 at the moment. Let's open a Windows console. CD to my current project. For using .NET Upgrade, you need to run Upgrade Assistant, space upgrade, and pass to your CS project or DLL you would like to upgrade. It runs a small analyze process, and you can see like step-by-step solution of what you need to do in case for upgrade. So you need to update NuGet packages, fix warnings like HTTP client, HTML helper, unsafe deserialize, etc. You could do it by applying commands in a console or do it manually yourself. It is highly useful tool, and I highly recommend it. I mentioned also Analyzer. So you need to install it into your Visual Studio. From Analyze tab, you should choose Portability Analyzer Settings. And there are a variety of settings to choose. For example, you could choose, can I port to .NET Core 3.1? Or can I port to, let's say, .NET Standard Platform 2.0? You save your settings. And from Analyze, you choose Analyze Assembly Portability. Analyze library you would like to check for it. Let's say it would be WinForm library, bin, debug, DLL. It runs a small process. You can open directory. And here you can see that from WinForms, we can port our library to .NET Core version 3.1, to .NET Framework 4.6.2, but not to .NET Standard because there are some dependency issues in it. And you can actually see where a problem lies in our breaking changes. Also highly useful tool, and I recommend it to you. Next thing is, so everyone, maybe not everyone, are confused by .NET Standard versioning rules. So there are only two rules in .NET versioning. The first one is addictive. .NET Standard are logically connected with each other. So version 1.2 is like evolution of version 1.1, and they are immutable. Once they are shipped, there would be no breaking changes at all to these versions, and you could safely use them as you want. Just to recap, I posted this picture again, so you could see it as an example. I would like also mention a couple of common issues as that you could face during using of .NET Standard. The first one is the most common issue, like if your sample library CS project targets .NET Standard, it could not be referenced inside other projects like .NET Framework version 4.0. It could be easily fixed by updating, downgrading your library to earlier version, like not .NET Standard 2.0, but maybe .NET Standard 1.0, and it could be used still in .NET Core 3.0 and in older .NET framework versions. Other issue I would like to tell you, probably people who already used .NET Standard, they've seen an error like your Visual Studio could not find a byte, or it could not find a string value, or it could not find int value. That's because they are using a different assembly versions to search default types. One uses system runtime, and other uses Microsoft library. And it was fixed in .NET Standard 2.0. But if it's not fixed in .NET Standard 2.0, you could add to your project .NET Standard DLL, and it emulates Microsoft lib.dll. And you would eliminate this problem of unable to find base types in your project. Next thing I would like to mention is not all libraries from .NET Framework are ported into .NET Standard or .NET Core or .NET 5. And Microsoft and open source community are aware of this issue and rapidly adding new libraries to newest releases. But if it's still missing in like latest .NET release, there is a library called Microsoft Windows Compatibility Library, and you should check if your favorite library still exists in this compatibility tool. It was much faster than I expected. I've run out of topics. I would appreciate if you have any questions or suggestions.